Well, hello there, I'm Green Deane, and welcome to my video number 94. Today on a pretty rare plant you won't find too often, but it's one of my favorite. And when you do find it, it's a grand day because it's a delicious but ignored fruit. And that's the Natal Plum, or Carissa macrocarpa. Before we go out into the field, let's take a look at a photograph of the Natal Plum. Notice the big cranberry red ripe fruit with a point on the end. And if you'll also notice, the leather-like leaves have a point on the end also. The leaves grow opposite and are very oval. The flowers are star-like, 5 petals. And also notice right above the ripe fruit, there's an unripe green one. Another characteristic of this plant is double thorns. This lovely plant is a natal plum. Look at these, aren't they beautiful? 5-petal blossom, a lot of double thorns on it. Pretty, very pretty, pretty plant. Usually found in landscaping. These fruit are absolutely delicious. The cousin of this plant is the oleander. And the oleander, of course, is quite toxic. Oh, here we got a one with a bug on it. Lovely plant. Probably this is the best specimen I've ever seen of this particular plant. It fruits almost year-round. It flowers and fruits almost year-round, depending upon where you are. I've usually found this plant in landscaping. I've seen it in landscaping in Southern California, Central Florida, places like that. It doesn't transplant too well. Well, let's see here. Here's some flowers. Aren't they lovely? Take a look at the fruit. In fact, let me pick a couple. There's a fruit. Lovely red fruit. Fruit has latex in it, but you can eat the latex, just like figs have latex. I can't speak highly enough of this particular plant and fruit. It's absolutely delicious. It truly is. Whenever you come across this, it's well worth collecting and making into various pies and recipes. Lovely, lovely plant. This should be used far more often for landscaping than it is. Let's take one more good look at this. One more good look at this great plant. I also want to thank the owner for letting me take a picture of it. It has double thorns, one of the identifying characteristics. I looked at it real carefully here. There are some double thorns right there. A little hard to see, but thorns are always in pairs. Makes it hard to trim, but it's also one of the prime identifying characteristics of this plant. I've been seeing this plant beachside now for about 30 years. Lovely, lovely plant. Look at this. Look at that beautiful color. Isn't that wonderful? And the flavor is fantastic, absolutely fantastic. Now I know where to get some. Matter of fact, I'll use these seeds and start my own. I couldn't be happier. Look, here's twins. Here's a couple right here. Beautiful. Plenty of fruit down in there, look at that. Natal plum. Here's our natal plum. It's a little smaller than a commercial plum. It's not really a plum. Notice it has a pointed tip, flat on this side. What I want to show you is the latex after you cut it open. So, put it down here, get out my trusty knife. As you can see, it has a lot of latex. However, it's edible, just like the latex in a fig is edible. The flavor is like a sweet cranberry, and the texture is like that of a strawberry. Absolutely delicious fruit. It should become a commercial product. Natal Plum. And just for curiosity's sake, here's what the seeds look like. They resemble little rolled oats. Flat. Round. Here on Eat the Weeds, we itemize. So let's itemize the natal plum. And we start with identification. It's a much branched evergreen. It has thorns and pears. They can be short, they can be long, depending upon its growth habits. It has a milky sap. It has thick, glossy, dark green leaves, very leather-like, and they're opposite, and they have little pointy tips on them. The blossoms are star-shaped, you know, five petals. To the touch, they're kind of waxy, and they're very aromatic. And the fruit also has a little point on it. And a few mosquitoes here today. And the time of year. Well, actually, where they grow, they will fruit and blossom year-round, although they fruit heavily in the spring and summer. But you can find blossoms and fruit on them almost throughout the entire year. Environment. They can tolerate dry, salty, windy areas, so they're excellent for coastal uses or desert uses. You find them exclusively in landscaping. I don't think they're naturalized anywhere other than their native Africa. And in fact, the landscaping, or forgotten landscaping, they were used a lot many, many years ago. So I find them in contemporary landscaping, but I also find them around abandoned buildings and places where they took the buildings down but didn't take the plants out. So I've seen them anywhere from, you know, from Florida to California, and they're also in other warm areas around the world. Method of preparation. That's pretty easy. It's a very versatile plant. The ripe red fruit can be used for out of hand, take it off the tree. Jellies, jams, pies, drinks, makes an excellent sauce to put on things. It's a very wonderful, tasty fruit. And the seeds, eating the seeds is a matter of personal preference. You can either leave the seeds in or take them out. If you're going to make a sauce or something, you'd want to take the seeds out. If you're going to make a jam, you might want to leave them in. Now, some references say the seeds are toxic. Well, you know, I've eaten a heck of a lot of seeds, and I've never felt anything from it, and I'm still here. So I don't think that is accurate, or it must be in some amount or whatever. I mean, I don't eat 10 or 15 of these things at a time, so I'm really not sure. But I eat two or three, and the seeds have never bothered me. One warning, the rest of the plant, although the ripe fruit is edible, the rest of the plant is toxic, just like its cousin the oleander. The only part of the plant that is edible is a very ripe red fruit. You know, it's always delightful to find another natal plum. It tastes great and makes an excellent hedge on top of that. So thanks for joining me here on my video number 94 for the natal plum. If you want to know more, you can go to eattheweeds.com and read about the natal plum and over 500 other plants. So until next time, this is Green Deane. I want you to think green, I want you to eat green, and that includes the delicious natal plum. Mmm. Oh, what a way to start the day. Mmm. Oh, that's so good. Toodles.